Hey, what's up, guys? This is ComputerMadMan here. And, oh my god, the day has come. 15th of July, this is the day where I downgrade from Windows 10, and we're going to be going back to Windows 7. Currently, at the moment, as you can see, I am still on Windows 10 at the moment. But I've finished all my backups and things, because that's what I said I was going to be doing the last week and the previous week before that. So yeah, basically, this is what I've been backing up on. It's just a little micro SD USB stick. So basically what it is you just, you probably can't see it because the camera's not that great, but it's a 8GB micro SD card, which goes into this USB card reader. So it's 8GB. And that's what I've been using to basically do all my backups with to get prepared for Windows 10. So, let me just put the lid on. There we go. Yeah, so I just want to show you what's been going on. Basically, what I've had to do, because this USB is only like 8GB, basically what I've been having to do is like take 8GB off the laptop, move it down to my mum's computer, take another 8GB off here and move it back down, but I was able to clear some space out, so I mean that was pretty much worth it, to be honest. I was able to clear out quite a big amount of space, so I'm just going to head down now just to show you guys what the files are and stuff. So I'm just going to head downstairs real quick. Like I say, no pausing throughout the video because I want to make it as similar to a live stream as possible. So yeah, I just want to make it as similar to a live stream as I like possibly can. But this is my mum's computer. You probably can't see it too well because it's a bit dark over in this corner. But yeah, she's on Windows 7. Thank God. That's where I'm going to be heading. And no more of this shit. Look, get Windows 10. No thanks. I don't know, I might upgrade to it in the future, I don't know. But this is the laptop backups folder, and as you can see, I've got my sister's account, game backups, my account, and some extra folders that were quite big. I mean, all together, if I highlight all these and then go to like properties, it'll take a little bit of a while, I think, for the file sizes to get in order, but it's quite large. As you can see, all together, it takes about 18.9, and I had to do 8GB. Each way, so that's with all of it together. But I'm just going to look at each of them just to see. So Chloe's is, my sister's account's 4.76, so I was able to do that all in one go, which was nice. Game backups wasn't too big, I think it was only, yeah, 400 megabytes. My account was 5.5. But it was really weird because when I went to transfer it at first, it said it was 10GB, but then for some reason it said it was only 5, so I don't know what on earth was going on there. But this other folder, which is Chloe's Sean 2016, that's total of 5GB, so I could only do that in one go. And then I got my YouTube folder as a spare one, which is 3.28. So basically inside mine and my sister's one, it's simply just all the you know, the things where you have like desktop and you have all the desktop items and you have all the downloads, my documents, music, you know, all those sort of basic like folders. And then what I can do is when I've restored them, I can just move them back to where they're supposed to go. But obviously, as you can see, I've got my Computer Madman folder there, so but yeah, that's literally where all the backups are, so I'm just going to so they're all safe. Hopefully nothing will go wrong with them because I've only made one backup that shouldn't go wrong. So I'm just going to head back upstairs and head back to the laptop just to show you what's on the USB at the moment. Ooh. Alrighty. So we're back at the laptop. I'm just going to put the USB in. It. And now we're just going to head to where we got to go for it. Where is it? This PC. Where is it? Ah, there it is. Okay, there we go. So this is currently the USB drive. A bit of a weird name, that's just how it came out. But basically I've formatted it so that now it's actually a boot device and I've actually got the Windows 7 actually on here. But before I go into it, I just want to show you guys how you can actually get this Windows 7 ISO. Now, first of all, I just want to say that there are actually two different things that you can look for, basically. The first page that I did actually go to was Microsoft's page. I'll just type in if the bloody keyboard would decide to work, but it's not. On M. What's going on? The fucking keyboard's not working. Just because Edge hasn't. I don't think Edge is loaded properly. Oh, piss off! Just load! Bloody hell, just load. That's all I want you to do, is just load. Right, okay, there we go. Yeah, this was the link that I actually did find originally. It was for a software download for Windows 7, so if I just go to that. I'm glad it highlighted, actually, because I didn't have to retype it until my Wi-Fi is on. My router's on downstairs, so it should be alright to go. Hopefully the quality's not too bad. Because I was going to do 720p, but I actually then ended up putting it to, well, on this camera you can get 640 by 480, which I think, when I looked on the internet, it's like 480p on YouTube. Oh, come on, what's going on with this internet? Look at it, it's just spinning, what the fuck? Oh, come on, I'm sure the internet's not that bad. I've got three bars out of four. Oh, I don't even know what's going on. Alright. Let's try Internet Explorer, because for some reason Edge is being a douche. I don't want to load anything. Where is it? Ooh, apps. Where is it? Accessories. There we go, Internet Explorer. Yeah, it's going to be good going back to Internet Explorer and Windows 7. Oh, I don't want to load Microsoft's, like, crappy MSN bullshit page. It's just that this loads a bit faster. Okay, I don't know what the fuck's going on. Okay, hold on, let me just, like, disconnect and then just hope that works. Oh yeah, disconnect. Then I'll turn my Wi-Fi button off, turn it back on. And then we'll just reconnect back to it. For some reason it's being a fucking douche and don't want to work. Checking network requirements. There we go, connected. Okay. Actually, I could try the Google browser. I got the Google browser. There's three different browsers I'm trying now. Are you going to load or... Alright, so we'll just put that link in. Oh god, I just duplicated it. Oh no, flipping back button's crashed. Oh my god, what is going on with this fucking internet? What? Alright, back to Edge. Say, man, all I want to do is load one simple website. I didn't know it was this difficult. What is going on with this shit? Just load. Okay, right, it's loading now. This is now saying the... Oh, come on, don't say not responding, you piece of shit. It will, we just gotta wait for it. Basically, I'm just going to explain it here, just in case it doesn't work. Basically, what there is when you get Windows 7, there's two different types that you can get. I don't mean the, you know, Home Edition or you know, any of the other things like that. Basically what I mean is, you can get two different ones. You can either get an OEM version of the ISO, or either you can get a retail. Mine is, basically the OEM is one, is a product key for Windows 7 that's built into your system when you first bought it. So say if you bought a laptop that had Windows 7, that's an OEM, because it's built into the system. So basically this was the first site that I went to, because I thought this one was right, and luckily I checked it yesterday, and after entering the product key, apparently this product key is only for retail. And what I mean by retail is only if you bought it from a second-hand vendor, such as, like, from a secondary vendor, such as, like, Amazon, Microsoft's website, you know, basically different places that host Windows 7 online that you can buy and then use to upgrade. But if you have an OEM, which is, like, say if you bought a laptop or computer that has Windows 7 built in, your product key won't work. So I'm just going to show you the second website where I did actually find an ISO for it. It was a great website. It's just this guy that's got like a giant server full of it. So I'm just gonna head over to it now. I did write it down. Bear with me. HTTP /// mirror.corey. Corey Knock. What was it? Digital River. CoreyKnock.de/ I think it might have been this one. CoreyKnock.digitalriver.net. Yeah, this is it. So it's mirror.CoreyKnock.de/digitalriver.net. Now, basically, what this is, it's simply just some guy's server where he's actually set it up so that you can have all the ISOs. And as you can see, there's absolutely tons here. These are all the different ISOs for it. So you've got... But what you've got to check here is you've got to check this side here where it says next to the Windows name, if you can't see it properly. If you look on the towards the middle of the screen where it is now, it says DE. Basically, I think what this means is the language. So that one's DE. EN, as you can see, the purple one that I've downloaded is Windows 7 Home Premium with SPL X64, because mine's a 64-bit operating system, and the U in the DVD means apparently updated, but I'm not sure. It was based on a Reddit thread. So EN is obviously English, and then you've got FR, which is France, I presume, and then you've got another one which is like RU for Russia. I'm not really too sure on the others. But like I say, you get Home Premium, you've got Starter, you've got Professional, and you've even got like Ultimate and Enterprise. So, like I say, you get quite a lot there. And I love this comment though, where it says, if you're a Microsoft representative, please don't be pissed. I just help your customers where you leave them in the dark. Wait, I can't read the last bit. I do not provide keys here, thank you. And I just love that comment, because they literally do, because apparently people are saying they stopped supplying the ISOs, and I think it's the fact that Microsoft are just greedy, like, money bag whores that just want everyone to upgrade to Windows 10, which is fucking bullshit, because the people that don't want it. I mean, I wouldn't say I don't want it, I just want to go back to Windows 7, because I prefer it. But yeah, like I say, when you look for the download, obviously look for your region name, and then look for what edition you have. Obviously mine's Home Premium. They've all got Service Pack 1, I think, but that doesn't matter. As long as you have a valid like license key for it, then that's fine. Then it will work. And then the U obviously means it's been updated. Now, what you got to look for as well is this part that says X64 and X86. So X86 means it's a 32-bit operating system, and X64 means it's a 64-bit. It's a little bit confusing, I know, but just remember that 64 is a 64-bit operating system, and 86 is 32, for some reason. Now, when you first click on these, it will actually open as a torrent. So also as well, I just want to say that in any way, if you can give this guy credit, then that would be absolutely awesome, because this guy's worked extremely hard to get all these things up there. And if you find the Reddit post that posted this, and, you know, because, you know, he deserves support, because he was the one that messaged about this link, and people were saying, oh yeah, it's amazing, it works, and all this, so, yeah, absolutely amazing to this guy. But like I say, it just opens a new torrent, so all I'm going to do is head to my downloads, just so I can show you it in action. Now, I said at first that I wasn't particularly fond of using a torrent, because of the fact that I didn't want it to have viruses, but because the website isn't actually a torrent website, then I'm quite happy with it. But basically, it's 3.9 gig. When I downloaded it, I was probably getting about 1.5 meg per second speed, and it took about half an hour to download, which was why I didn't want to show you guys downloading it, because it was going to take too long. So like I say, it took about, yeah, half hour to download, and I was getting about 1.5 meg per second, the download speed, the health of it was all good, so it was a really good, smooth download. But once you do have the ISO, simply what you're going to want to do is download a tool that's called Rufus. Basically, Rufus is just a simple, like, program that's used to format USBs to make them bootable. So once you get in it, it will identify what USB device you've got. You want to leave all the options to default. And then down here, all you have to do is just select what ISO, what thingy you want to put in. You want ISO. Then you click the little disk drive icon, and then you just have to browse to where your ISO is. So mine should open, and it will come up here. This is my ISO after it downloaded. And then all that will happen is it will select it, and then all you have to do... I'll just demonstrate. I'll open it. And then it will say here, it will say whether you want a standard Windows installation or Windows Go. And then it will change the file system to NTFS, just keep that the same, it doesn't matter. And then once you hit start, it will roughly take about 20 minutes to get going. So half an hour for the download, 20 minutes for the format of the USB, I suppose. But that might be based on what USB you've got and whether it's like faster than mine. But I'm just going to show you my USB now. So as you can see, this is the drive. And as you can see, we've got all the boot stuff, boot manager, we've got the setup all in there, so it's all practically ready to go. So here we go, guys, this is the big part now. I'm sorry it took about like 18 minutes to get into it, but I just had to get all that stuff out of the way. So, because if you guys wanted to downgrade, I just wanted to show you what would happen if I did do it. I will leave the links down below in the description so you guys can do it as well. So what we're going to do is we're going to shut it off, just so I can get it into the BIOS and then set it as my default boot. So goodbye Windows 10. I will miss some of your stuff, but overall I just prefer Windows 7. You're not crap, I just prefer Windows 7, honestly. Just wait for it to shut off because the light's still glowing. Come on, turn off. Turn off. Turn off. And that's the other weird thing. For some reason, like Windows 10, it takes forever to turn off. I don't know what goes on with it. It's weird. Windows 7, it was like click your fingers, whereas this, you have to wait a bit for it. Okay, there we go. Now I've got to... I'm not sure how to get it into the BIOS. I think it's like F2? Possibly, I don't know. Ah, yeah, F2. Oh, shit, what did I press? What's this? Oh, I'm in the hardware diagnostics. Okay, no, we just want to... Are you sure? No. Oh, are you sure? Yeah, I want to exit. I can't... Damn it, I've lost it. Okay. Shut it off. I think it's usually one of the default either like F10 or F11 ones, I think. Ah, what the fuck? Okay, we're into the BIOS. I don't know how I've done it, but... Okay, right, we're good. So, where it is... It's not... Ah, system configuration boot options. Okay, legacy boot, I think it's legacy boot order. UEFI boot order, I don't know what the hell that is. On key USB hard disk. So how do I move it up? F5 or F6? Oh, okay, F6 moves it up. USB, CD, DVD, or ROM drive. So, was it F5 or F6? Just nudge that up. I don't think it's the UEFI order, I think it's legacy. I know, I'm pretty sure there is a boot. Okay, what's exit and save? F10. You sure? Yes. Alright, so we'll see whether that works. If not, I can just shut it down again. Ah, press any key to boot from USB, that's what I want. Alright, Windows is loading fast. Alright, sweet. I had a feeling that something was going to go wrong there. I just hope this don't take too long. Hopefully. It's not bad, we're 21 minutes in, but... Okay, alright, here we go, we got the background in Windows 7 again now. Alrighty, okay, right. Let's do this. So, yeah, English. We're not from the United States. No, I'm not American. No, we want not American. I can't do American accent. Excuse me for that. Keyword input method, United Kingdom. Next. What does it say here? What to know before installing Windows, repair your computer. No, I'm just going to install. Alright, setup is starting. Let's go. Yeah, I just want to talk as well about some other stuff I'm going to be doing on this as well. I've wrote down the programs that I'm keeping as well. Probably can't see it. Oh, okay, never mind, I'll have to leave that. Right, okay, we've got license terms and conditions. I don't read that crap. Next. Right. This was the part where I actually wanted to make the backup. So it says, which type of installation? Upgrade to a newer version of Windows and keep your files. Settings and prone. The option that goes only available when an existing system Windows is running. I would have done an upgrade, but I don't know where it's going. I don't think it'll personally work. Alright, you can pack computer starting using Windows installation disk. Need the installation disk and restart your computer so that Windows starts normally, then insert the installation disk. Oh, I don't know. No, since I've backed it up, I'm just going to do it as a clean wipe. I would do that, but like I said, I just don't want to mess up the install, so I'm just going to go to the custom advance and just wipe everything. Install a new copy of Windows. Plus as well, it'll make it faster if I install a new copy and more clean. This option does not keep your file settings and programs. The option to make changes to disks and partitions is available when you start a computer using installation disk. We recommend backing up your files. Alright, okie dokie. So we've got Windows can't be installed and partition. Alright, okay. Well, I don't know what to do, I don't know whether to delete it or whether to just format it. Probably do format first. Partition might contain recovery files as far as important software for a few moments, yeah. I've already backed it, because that second partition's where I've got all my data on it. And then the top one's just the system reserve, so it doesn't take too long. Alright, there we go. And then we'll just format this one to get Windows 10 off of it. That's it. probably delete that one now, actually, because we've still got the first partition there. We'll delete the top one as well. So now we've just got an allocated space. We'll do... Oh, can we not do next? Oh, we can. Okay. So we'll do next. Yeah, I want to install the unallocated space. There we go. Installing Windows. This is the part that's going to probably take a while, so... I'll just go through my programs, because this is going to take a long bit. So these are the programs that I've got. So I had a VAST, obviously, to protect from malware and all that shit. Bandicam, obviously, to do my YouTube videos. CCleaner, to help with computer performance and things. FreeMake Video Converter is mainly for my YouTube, so I can convert videos to work in video players and things like that. Horizon is my modding tool for my Xbox. I don't really use it that much anymore, but might do. iTunes is basically for my iPhone, my sister's iPad, and her iPhone as well, because I've actually got an iPhone, it's cool. Microsoft Office, I'm not going to get a crack. I know I did before, but but I don't really want a crack because, I don't know, I just don't think cracks run as smooth as the actual thing. So, and plus I don't want to have the risk of getting a virus when I've just installed Windows 7. Duh. So, I'm either going to get a trial or look for an alternative. One of them I was looking at was Polaris Office. I've actually got it on the tablet, which is what I'm recording from. And it's actually proper sick. I mean, it's literally just virtually identical to Office, apart from it's free. So it's awesome. Movie Maker, I'm going to probably get the live version, because as you know, in Windows 10 I had to use 2.6, because, basically Live Movie Maker was broken on Windows 10, so I couldn't use it. And then the other one is Adobe Photoshop, which I use for my YouTube thumbnails. I'm either going to get a trial or try and look for a free alternative somewhere. But I don't really know of any free alternatives, so I'll probably just look for a trial. And yeah, that's it really. For the programs. So yeah, what are we doing? 13. Probably guys get sick of my voice light soon. It's like outside. It's alright, a bit cloudy, but... You know. So like I said, this is going to take a bit of time, but... Oh, shit! Oh, God, I actually forgot I'm supposed to plug in my charger. I forgot. Oh, give me that plug. There we go. There we go. I completely forgot I was supposed to put the charger in case it, like, ran out. Because that would be the worst thing, though, if I go to install it and then the charger runs out or something like that. That would piss me off. And then the charger runs out and it dies halfway through the install. That would just piss me off. So... Oh, shit. That was close. It's just hope I don't accidentally press them on the screen or drop my tablet. That's the ever worst thing as well. Let me just look at some of the things that I said that I'd talk about in the video. I actually made a list of like topics to talk about because I'm not very talkative sometimes. So I'd end up sitting in silence waiting for it to finish and you guys would be bored as shit. I've got a mark on the screen. Okay, it's gone. Okay. Right. Right. So I've done that. In that one. What did I miss? How to get bootable ISO media, I've done that. Will it get Windows 10 in the future? Everything goes right, I've done that. I've said about this, 360 before 82. Can't believe I'm actually having to scribble it out one-handed, don't matter. Okay, right. So there's a few things I still haven't talked about yet. Mainly one of them is why I wanted to downgrade in the first place. So I think the main reason why I wanted to downgrade was just the fact that Windows 7 is very much more simplistic than Windows 10. Because I don't use a laptop very often, I only usually tend to use it, like, mainly for YouTube now. Maybe I'll play the occasional game on it, but not a lot. But it's the fact that Windows 10 is good, but I think it just offers too many, like, features. You know, there's just so much there in Windows 10, and it's just stuff that I don't really need. You know, and there's just so many, you know, different things to take into account of it. I just don't want it. It's a very sort of cluttered operating system. It's got quite a lot there. It's good, but... And no, like I say, Windows 7's just more, like, simplistic. And it's just more for what I need it for. There are a few things I'm going to miss from Windows 10, though, such as the Windows Store, because I absolutely love the Windows Store. Because, I mean, you know, on the Windows Store, you can always download all those arcade games, which you could never do before. You know, it was all of a sudden like a new platform for gaming on PC. You know, you were able to get, you know, those Android and Apple games, the arcade stuff, and you were actually able to get them on your computer. And the good part was they don't take, you know, they don't require a lot of graphics processing. You know, you don't need a really good CPU, you don't need lots of RAM, you don't need lots of, you know, high-spec stuff. You know, and that was what made it good, because I had quite a few games on there. You know, and they all ran smoothly, and it was just amazing. So, I mean, that I am truly, truly going to miss, but, you know, I can still get other low-end games, just obviously not these arcade sorts anymore. So, we're on 71. Okay, it's going actually a bit quicker than what I expected. The other one I'm going to miss as well is the Microsoft 3D Builder. You guys might not have seen it before, but there's actually a 3D Builder application. And it was one of my friends, actually, who got me into, like, this 3D building thing. Because he's got a gaming PC, and he's got, like, a 3D building thing on it. And it wasn't Microsoft 3D Builder. It was something more complicated than that. And he was building, like, a model gun or something. I can't remember what one it was. It was, like, an M4... or an M4A1, something like that, I don't exactly know, but it looks pretty, like, sick, and, you know, he has all this inspiration from all these other YouTubers that do it, and, you know, it looked really awesome, and then, you know, when I saw the 3D Builder was there, I thought, yeah, I've got to try it, but the problem with 3D Builder is you need a lot of time on your hands to do it, and I just never had that time. You know, I kind of got played around with it a little bit, but I just never really got into it, because I needed the time to do it, and I just didn't have it. I'm going to try and see if I can get it on Windows 7, but I doubt I will. Or either that, I could look for another third-party one. But no, besides from that, there's not much that I'm going to miss. I mean, I will miss probably the start menu tiles and the colours and things, but you can do that on Windows 7. If you go to Aero, you can change the Aero theme colour. So, you know, you can get reds, browns, whites, blacks, you know, so... You know, I didn't see anything on there. The other thing on my list was would I actually go back up to Windows 10. And I mean, personally, I don't know. I think it's probably going to be based off of my sister. If she wants, you know, if she's not fussed what one to get, I'd probably rather go with a PC that has Windows 7. But I don't know. But you get all these new PCs that have got all these laptops that have got these i7 processors and... You know, things like that. They've got all these new, bigger, higher amounts of memory. They're thinner, they're faster. You know, and some of them have these, like, Beats Audio thing, which I think is quite cool. But no, I just don't know. I don't think I'll probably go for a tower, because I kind of actually prefer laptops now, to be honest, just because of the fact that you don't have to have them constantly plugged in. They're just all nice and lightweight. And then plus you don't have to buy the accessories, so... Oh, that's good. It's done the installation files, it's done the features, just gotta do the updates now. I don't know. It's just really difficult whether I would go for Windows 10 or whether I would go for... I mean, if I go for a newer PC, obviously it's going to... PC will restart. Okay, well, obviously it's going to cost more. if I go for a PC that's got Windows 10, because it's newer, and it's going to have all the newer hardware and stuff, Windows 7 will be cheaper. I presume I got a boot from USB. Or they'd have to let it run to the hard drive. I might have had to let it run to the hard drive, but I don't know. We'll just see what happens, because it might carry on from the USB. But I don't think it will. I think, from remembering when I'd done this on a friend's PC, because I had to fix their PC was broken, and had like Windows XP on it and all that, I had to actually end up... Okay, no, I think I was supposed to back out. Alright, that's fine, so we'll shut it off. Take you out. Alright, okay, so now I presume we just got to boot back up to the hard drive now. And then the hard drive continues from there, I think. At least I presume so, anyway. I've got the Windows 7 logo now. After we took out the USB, so... I presume it's working. Ah, okay, setup is updating register. Yeah, so it is carrying on. Alright, well, that's good. Right. No, I'm just not sure that Windows 10 for the future thing. I honestly don't know. I'm really sort of, like, torn with it. I don't know. It's very... very tough at the minute. Okay, so we've done the updates, now I just gotta completely install. I just need to rest a bit. I don't know how long this is going to take, because it doesn't have a timer, it doesn't have a percentage either. Actually, wait, I've got an idea. I'll be back in a second. I'm going to do something special when it installs and brings it up at the desktop. It's like outside still. Still cloudy. Sort of. Shouldn't rain, but don't know. Oh, and if you guys are wondering what laptop I have, it's actually a HP 655. Because I don't think I've actually shown you guys the laptop before. It's quite a nice laptop. Well, technically it's not actually a laptop, it's actually a netbook. But it's quite a big netbook. And essentially it's got like 4GB of RAM. I think it's got like a... it's not the highest spec like thing. It's got an AMD Radeon 4340 graphics card. Not the best, but it does the job though. Everything's all nice and crisp on screen, so... I like it. I've had it for about, like, coming up to 3 years now. And, oh, and I think that's one of the other reasons why I wanted to downgrade as well, is because this laptop's quite old, and it's having to run a new system, I think it kind of struggled at times. And, like, you know, it just used to really sort of, like, struggle, which is the other reason why I wanted to downgrade. Whereas Windows 7 is the system it should be on, because it's sort of got a sticker. So... you know, obviously the hardware is intended for Windows 7, which is why, you know, I just wanted to bring it back to where it should be. Ah, here we go. Set will continue after restarting your computer. So this time we can actually get onto the desktop this time. What the hell? I'm not connected to the internet. My phone's not connected to you. Oh, okay. Bit slow. Yeah, setup is preparing your computer for the first time! Oh, alright, here we go. Yeah, Windows 7 Home. So this is obviously the main setup now, isn't it? Type your username. Well, because obviously I'm going to be setting up first, and on the administrator I'm going to put Jordan. Type a computer name. I'll put Jordan space. I can't reach the thing. Oh wait, can you not use that? Oh, okay, probably can't use it. We'll just put Jordan and oh, apparently it's all put. Let's just put JMH what and CMH. Yeah, we'll just put JMH and CMH. Because mine's Jordan Musethold and Chloe's is Chloe Musethold, so we'll do that. Next. Type a password. Okay. Oh, retype password in. Not telling you guys that. Oh shit, accidentally. Fuck! Oh, I hate when that shit happens. You're typing it out and then you accidentally do the wrong letter. It's so ball. I think I got that right. Glad I haven't moved the camera down, or else you guys would have been able to see the password. Have a password hint. I won't show you that bit, because you guys might get the password. Alright, okay, we'll just go on to next. Oh god, type your product here, this is the part I'm dreading the most. Shit. Now the product key is difficult for me, because it's right on the underside. You can skip it actually. It's right on the underside here, but the sticker's the wrong way around. Okay, so I'm gonna have to put the screen down, because I can't hold it and try and lift the laptop at the same time. So I'll just have to put it down, sorry. Just bear with me while I enter this product key. I'm still making sure though that it's not actually like turning off. Almost there, just on the last five characters. Alright, okay. So, next, and hopefully that should work. Don't do that stupid spinny thing, just go next, please. You watch, it'll probably pop up saying that it's wrong. I always have this worst fear every time I have to enter a product key that's going to come up saying it's wrong. Like, every time. I ain't going to touch it just in case I, like, crash the install, so I'm just going to leave it as is. I just pray it don't take too long. Hold on a sec. I don't know, do I dare click it again? Like I said, I don't want to click it and then it like crashes it. I don't know what it's doing, whether it has crashed. Oh, there we go. Thank God. I think I must have just been seeing whether it was correct or not. Help take your computer and improve Windows. Yeah, we'll do recommended settings. Time zone. UTC, Edinburgh, London. I'm sure that is the right one. Because we're in UTC. Shit, I've lost it now. Oh, there it is, yeah. Automatically just clocked, daylight settings, Friday the 15th. Is it 9:14? Well, 9:15. We'll just change that. Probably 16, actually. Alright, okay, we'll do next. There we go, finalising your settings. So obviously it did go through. Ooh, shit, I'm there. Oh, we're going on! Oh, prepare you to run! Oh, come on, please. Yes! Yeah! Oh, come on, yes! Oh, I gotta play this now. Oh, I gotta play this now. It might be cringe, but I don't give a shit. It's worth it. Came up and smiled at me. And it's gonna be a good one, just wait and see. I know this is cringe, but I've gotta play it. Jumped out of bed and I ran outside. Best day ever. Best day ever. Oh, I'm catwalking across the keyboard. Oh, thank God. I don't remember it being this long. Oh, so good. So true, magic before my eyes, it is. I don't know the most of these words. Oh. Don't remember that bit. It's the best day ever. It's
a bad day ever. It's the best day ever. It's the best day ever.
Don't hate on me. I still like SpongeBob. Don't diss. You can't diss that song. You just can't. That's it now. We're finally back on Windows 7 now. Hold on. Just wait a second. 7, 3. Oh, come on, just play. Hopefully I don't get copyright to this, but I just want to play it. I'll just turn down a bit. Yeah, so that's it. So we got the classic start menu. It's a bit big for my screen, as in, you know, the resolution's not been set properly, but, you know, still all good. Dun, 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 dun. Celebration, celebrate the times, come on. I shouldn't get copyrighted for it, as long as I don't use the whole song. Celebrate, there's a party going on right here. A celebration, the last throughout the year. So when you're not on, and you're not here too. Alright, so yeah, that's virtually it, guys. I'm just going to end the video here because there's not really much else to talk about. Obviously, I've got to install some more updates and sort some stuff out, but aside from that, Windows 7's installed. And like I say, I just want to thank you guys so much for being here because, I mean, I wouldn't have had the inspiration to do this video if it weren't for you guys, you know, putting your thumbs up and commenting on some of my other tutorial videos. It just gives me the motivation and inspiration to keep going on and on and on to do this sort of stuff. And, you know, hopefully you guys give me all the positive feedback for this video, because I absolutely love you guys so much. I know I've let you down in the past so many times with different stuff, but you guys have been there all the time, and I absolutely love it. It's brilliant. My YouTube buffering videos on, like, 13,000 views, still getting likes and comments and things, and other videos are as well. Yo, it's absolutely great. I can't describe it at all. It's stunning. And there's just nothing much I can say apart from thank you guys so much. Yeah, because this wouldn't have been possible. I wouldn't even have been recording this without your guys' support, so all I can say is thank you so much. But I am going to be away for a few weeks, obviously, because I need to install all these programs, I need to get the backups back in order, and I just need to sort of change the settings on this, just so it's all up to scratch. So it is going to be quite a while I'm going to be away after this big event, but hopefully this big event will keep you entertained. And with that said, guys, we're back on Windows 7, and we are back where we belong. And that's it. So, I'll see you guys soon. Goodbye. Oh boy.